हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन। दिस इज फॉर क्लास फोर्थ सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स। आई विल कंटिन्यू चैप्टर नंबर 5 डिवीजन एंड दिस इज आवर लेक्चर नंबर 7। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर आई शैल डिस्कस अबाउट वर्कशीट गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 55। इन दिस लेक्चर आई शैल डिस्कस अबाउट वर्कशीट गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 55। नाउ सॉल्व दी फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस। वर्कशीट गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 55। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, फिल इन दी ब्लैंक्स। ए पार्ट 3745 मल्टीप्लाई 71 इक्वल टू 71 मल्टीप्लाई डैश। सी दिस इज दी प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन। ओके सी विच नंबर इज लेफ्ट। सी 3745, सो वी विल राइट हियर 3745। क्लियर? राइट डाउन आंसर। 3745 मल्टीप्लाई 71 इक्वल टू 71 मल्टीप्लाई 3745। क्लियर? नाउ बी पार्ट 9820 मल्टीप्लाई डैश इक्वल टू 0, सो वी विल मल्टीप्लाई बाय 0। राइट डाउन आंसर 9820 मल्टीप्लाई 0 इक्वल टू 0। क्लियर? नाउ सी पार्ट 327 मल्टीप्लाई डैश इक्वल टू 327। सी प्रोडक्ट इज द सेम नंबर, दैट इज 327, सो वी विल मल्टीप्लाई बाय 1। क्लियर? राइट डाउन आंसर 327 मल्टीप्लाई 1 इक्वल टू 327। नाउ डी पार्ट 6320 डिवाइडेड 1 इक्वल टू डैश। सी इफ यू आर डिवाइडिंग दिस नंबर बाय 1 देन यू विल गेट द सेम नंबर एज द क्वेश्चंट। क्लियर? राइट डाउन आंसर 6320 divided 1 equal to 6320. Clear? Now, E part 2132 divided 2132 equal to dash. See, if you are dividing any number by that same number itself, then you will get 1 as the quotient. Clear? Write down answer 2132 divided 2132 equal to 1. Now, F part. Dash divided 967 equal to 0. Dash divided 967 equal to 0. See, quotient is 0. So, you will write here 0. Clear? Write down answer 0 divided 967 equal to 0. Clear? Now, question number 2. State whether the following statements are true or false. State whether the following statements are true or false. A part 371 multiply 100 equal to 3710. See, first you will multiply 371 by 1 and then you will put two zeros at the last of this product. Clear? But product here it is written 3710. That is wrong. Clear? The product should be 37,100. Okay? So, this statement is false. Write down answer false. Now, B part, 0 multiply 10 equal to 100. No. If you will multiply 0 by any number, then you will get 0 as the product. But here, 100 is written. So, this statement is false. Write down answer false. Now, C part, 300 multiply 100 equal to 30,000. See, first multiply 3 by 1 and then put 4 zeros at the last of that product. Clear? So, here answer is correct, that is 30,000. So, this statement is true. Write down answer true. Now, D part. 26,000 divided 1,000 equal to 26. See, 3 zeros in dividend and 3 zeros in divisor. So, these zeros will be cut. Okay. So, 26 divided 1, that is equal to 26. So, this statement is true. Write down answer true. Now, E part 77,210 divided 10 equal to 7,72,100. See, 1 0 is written in dividend and 1 0 in divisor. So, this 0 will be cut. Now, 7,721 divided 1 equal to that same number, that is 7,721. But here, quotient is wrong. That is 7,72,100. So, this statement is false. Write down answer false. Now, F part 8000 divided 20 equal to 400. See, 3 zeros in dividend and 1 zero in divisor. So, 1 zero will be cut. So, 2 zeros will be left in dividend. Now, 8 divided 2 equal to 4 and then we will write 2 zeros. So, quotient equal to 400. So this statement is true. Write down answer true. Now question number 3. Find the quotient and the remainder. A part 603,137 divided 1000. Quotient equal to dash, remainder equal to dash. C. Divisor is 1000. So the number formed by the last three digits of the dividend, that is 1, 3 and 7. Number formed is 137. That will be remainder. And the number formed by the remaining digits, that is 6, 0 and 3. Number formed is 603. That will be quotient. Write down answer. 603,137 divided 1000. Quotient equal to 603. Remainder equal to 137. Clear? Now, B part. 50,123 divided 100. Quotient equal to dash. Remainder equal to dash. C divisor is 100. So the number formed by the last two digits of the dividend, that is 2 and 3. That is number formed is 23. That will be remainder. And the number formed by the remaining digits, that is 5, 0 and 1. Number formed is 501. That will be quotient. Write down answer. 50,123 divided 100. Quotient equal to 501. Remainder equal to 23. Now, C part. 5,76,921 divided 1000. Quotient equal to dash. Remainder equal to dash. C divisor is 1000. So, the number formed by the last three digits of the dividend, that is 9, 2 and 1. That number formed is 921. That will be remainder. And the number formed by the remaining digits, that is 5, 7 and 6. Number formed is 576. That will be quotient. Write down answer. 5,76,921 divided 1000. Quotient equal to 576. Remainder equal to 921. Clear? Now, question number 4. Divide and check your answer. A part 3,98,406 divided 83. Write down answer. Make a sign like this. Write 83 here and write 3,98,406 here. 83 is a two-digit divisor. So we will take only first two digits of the dividend, that is 39. But 39 is less than 83. So we will take one more digit, that is 8. Now number formed is 398. Now multiply this 83 by that number so that it is equal to 398 or less than 398. It should not be greater than 398. See, 83 multiply 4. 4 3 is a 12, write 2 here and 1 carry. 4 8 is a 32 plus 1, 33, write 33 here. 83 multiply 4 equal to 332. So multiply this 83 by 4. Write down 4 here and write down 332 here. Now we will do subtraction. 8 minus 2 6, write 6 here. 9 minus 3 6, write 6 here. 3 minus 3 0, write 0 here and then take next number, that is 4. Now the number formed is 664. Now see, 83 multiply 8. 8 3 is a 24, write 4 here and 2 carry. 8 8 is a 64, 64 plus 2, 66, write 66 here. 83 multiply 8 equal to 664. So multiply this 83 by 8. Write down 8 here and write down 664 here. Now we will do subtraction. 4 minus 4, 0. 6 minus 6, 0. 6 minus 6, 0. Okay, now take next number, that is 0. Now this 0 is less than 83. So we will write 0 in the quotient. Now take next number, that is 6. Now see, the 6 is less than 83. So now take one more 0 in the quotient. Now quotient equal to 4800 and remainder equal to 6. Write down quotient equal to 4800, remainder equal to 6. Clear? Now write down dividend equal to 3,98,406, divisor equal to 83, quotient equal to 4,800 and remainder equal to 6. Write down dividend equal to divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. 3,98,406 equal to 83 multiply 4,800 plus 6. First multiply 4,800 by 83. See, 4,800 multiply 83. 3 zeros are 0, write 0 here. 3 zeros are 0, write 0 here. 3 multiply 8. 24, write 4 here and 2 carry. 3 4s are 12 plus 2, 14, write 14 here. Now put 1 cross here. Now multiply 4800 by 8. 8 0s are 0, write 0 here. 8 0s are 0, write 0 here. 8 8s are 64, write 4 here and 6 carry. 8 4s are 32, 32 plus 6, 38, write 38 here. Now we will do addition. Write 0 here, 0 plus 0, 0. 4 plus 0, 4. 4 plus 4, 8. 1 plus 8, 9. And write 3 as it is. 4800 multiply 83 equal to 3,98,400. So write down 3,98,400 plus 6. Now add. After addition, that will be equal to 3,98,406. Now see, left hand side and right hand side both are equal. Hence, answer is verified. Now, question number 6. In the month of January, 9,424 people visited the Fun and Food Village. What was the number of visitors each day? See, January month में 9,424 people ने visit किया Fun and Food Village. What was the number of visitors each day? Means, हर दिन में कितने number of visitors visit किया January month में? तो सबसे पहले हम calculate करेंगे January month में कितने days हैं. उसके बाद हम calculate करेंगे number of visitors in each day. Okay, write down answer. Number of days in the month of January equal to 31 days. Now write down number of visitors visited village in 31 days equal to 9,424. Number of visitors visited village in one day equal to 9,424 divided 31. Make a sign like this, write 31 here and write 9,424 here. Now see, 31 is a two-digit divisor. So we will take only first two digits of the dividend, that is 9 and 4. Now number formed is 94. Now multiply this 31 by that number so that it is equal to 94 or less than 94. It should not be greater than 94. See, 31 multiply 3. 3 ones are 3, write 3 here. 3 threes are 9, write 9 here. 31 multiply 3 equal to 93. So multiply this 31 by 3. 31 multiply 3 equal to 93. Now we will do subtraction. 4 minus 3, 1, write 1 here. 9 minus 9, 0. And then take next number, that is 2. Now see, 12 is less than 31. So you will write 0 in the quotient. Now take next number, that is 4. Okay. Now multiply this 31 by that number so that it is equal to 124 or less than 124. It should not be greater than 124. See, 31 multiply 4. 4 ones are 4, write 4 here. 4 threes are 12, write 12 here. 31 multiply 4 equal to 124. See, 31 multiply 4 equal to 124. Now we will do subtraction. 4 minus 4, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. Clear? Write down. Therefore, the number of visitors in each day equal to 304. Number of visitors in each day equal to 304. Clear? Now, question number 9. Find a number which when divided by 35 gives the quotient 20 and the remainder 12. Write down answer. See, find a number which when divided by 35. It means divisor equal to 35 gives the quotient 20. Quotient equal to 20 and the remainder 12. And remainder equal to 12. We have to find the dividend. Clear? Write down. Dividend equal to divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. Write down equal to 35 multiply 20 plus 12. First multiply 35 by 20. See, 35 multiply 2. 35 multiply 2. See, 2 5s are 10. Write 0 here and 1 carry. 2 3s are 6. 6 plus 1 7. Write 7 here. 35 multiply 2 equal to 70. And then you will write 1 0 at the last of this product. So that will be equal to 700. So write down equal to 700 plus 12. 700 plus 12. That is equal to 712. So, dividend equal to 712. Clear? Now, solve the following questions assigned as homework. Worksheet given on page number 55. Question number 3. Find the quotient and remainder. D part 78,096 divided 1000. Quotient equal to dash. Remainder equal to dash. E part 736 divided 10. Quotient equal to dash. Remainder equal to dash. F part 450 divided 50. Quotient equal to dash. Remainder equal to dash. Now question number 4. Divide and check your answer. B part 707,070 divided 62. Question number 4. Divide and check your answer. B part 707,070 divided 62. Now question number 8. 24 mangoes can be packed in one carton. How many cartons will be needed to pack 2,448 mangoes? Question number 8. 24 mangoes can be packed in one carton. How many cartons will be needed to pack 2,448 mangoes? These are the questions assigned as homework. Now, I will discuss homework solutions of lecture number 6 of chapter number 5, division. Now, exercise 5D, question number 2. If 16 juice packets are packed in a box, then how many boxes are required to pack 4000 juice packets? अगर 16 juice packets packed होते हैं एक box में, तो हमें कितने box और चाहिए 4000 juice packets को pack करने के लिए? See, answer. Number of boxes required to pack 16 juice packets equal to 1 box. Number of boxes required to pack 4000 juice packets equal to 4000 divided 16. So make a sign like this, write 16 here and write 4000 here. See, 16 is a two-digit divisor, so you will take only first two digits of the dividend, that is 4 and 0. Number formed is 40. Clear? See, 16 multiplied 2 equal to 32. Then you will do subtraction. 0 minus 8, it is not possible. So we will take over from this 4. So this 4 will become 3 and this 0 will become 10. 10 minus 2, 8, write 8 here. 3 minus 3, 0, write 0 here. And then take next number, that is 0. Number formed is 80. Clear? 16 multiply 5 equal to 80. And then do subtraction. 0 minus 0, 0, 8 minus 8, 0. And then take next number, that is 0. So you will take this 0 as quotient. Clear? Write 0 in quotient. Understood? Now write down. Therefore, 250 boxes are required to pack 4000 juice packets. Therefore, 250 boxes are required to pack 4000 juice packets. Clear? Now, question number 5. 3800 bricks were ordered to make a wall. If one truck contains 950 bricks, how many trucks of bricks were ordered? 3800 bricks were ordered to make a wall. If one truck contains 950 bricks, how many trucks of bricks were ordered? See, answer. Number of bricks ordered to make a wall equal to 3800. Number of bricks in one truck equal to 950 bricks. Number of trucks of bricks ordered equal to 3800 divided 950. Make a sign like this. Write 950 here and write 3800 here. Now see, 950 is a 3-digit divisor. So you will take only first 3 digits of the dividend, that is 3, 8 and 0. Number formed is 380. But 380 is less than 950. So you will take one more digit, that is 0. Now the number formed is 3800. Now multiply this 950 by that number so that it is equal to 3800 or less than 3800. It should not be greater than 3800. See, 950 multiply 4. 4 zeros are 0, write 0 here. 4 fives are 20, write 0 here and 2 carry. 4 nines are 36 plus 2, 38, write 38 here. 950 multiply 4 equal to 3800. So multiply this 950 by 4. Okay, then do subtraction. 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0, 8 minus 8, 0, 3 minus 3, 0. Clear? Write down. Therefore, 4 trucks of bricks were ordered. Now, question number 6. 13 sales executives spend rupees 87,477 every day on conveyance. How much conveyance expense is done by each sales executive? Write down answer. Expense spent by 13 sales executives equal to rupees 87,477. Expense spent by one sales executive equal to rupees 87,477 divided 13. Make a sign like this. Write 13 here and write 87,477 here. Now multiply this 13 by 6. 13 multiply 6 equal to 78. Write down 6 here and write down 78 here. Now you will do subtraction. 7 minus 8, it is not possible. So we will take borrow from this 8. So this 8 will become 7 and this 7 will become 17. 17 minus 8, 9. 7 minus 7, 0. And then take next number, that is 4. Number formed is 94. 13 multiply 7 equal to 91. Now do subtraction. 4 minus 1, 3. Write 3 here. 9 minus 9, 0. And then take next number, that is 7. 13 multiply 2 equal to 26. Now do subtraction. 7 minus 6, 1, 3 minus 2, 1, and then take next number, that is 7. Number formed is 117. 13 multiply 9 equal to 117. And then do subtraction. 7 minus 7, 0, 1 minus 1, 0, 1 minus 1, 0. Clear? Write down. Therefore, rupees 6729 conveyance expense is done by each sales executive. Therefore, rupees 6729 conveyance expense is done by each sales executive. Now, question number 8. I divided 8125 by a number and got the answer 625. By which number did I divide? I divided 8125 by a number and got the answer 625. By which number did I divide? Clear? Write down answer. 8125 divided 625. We will divide 8125 by 625. Make a sign like this. Write 625 here and write 8125 here. Now see, 625 is a 3-digit divisor. So we will take only first 3 digits of the dividend, that is 8, 1 and 2. Number formed is 812. Clear? Now multiply this 625 by that number so that it is equal to 812 or less than 812. It should not be greater than 812. 625 multiply 1 equal to 625. And then we will do subtraction. 2 minus 5, it is not possible. So we will take borrow from this 1. So this 1 will become 0 and this 2 will become 12. 12 minus 5, 7, write 7 here. 0 minus 2, it is not possible. So we will take borrow from this 8. So this 8 will become 7 and this 0 will become 10. 10 minus 2, 8. 7 minus 6, 1. And then take next number, that is 5. Now number formed is 1875. See 625 multiply 3. 3 5s are 15, right 5 here and 1 carry. 3 2s are 6 plus 1 7, right 7 here. 3 6s are 18, right 18 here. 625 multiply 3 equal to 1875. Multiply this 625 by 3. Clear? Now we will do subtraction. 5 minus 5, 0. 7 minus 7, 0. 8 minus 8, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. Clear? Write down. Therefore, I divided 8125 by a number 13 and got the answer 625. Clear? Thank you. Have a nice day.